वेल नाउ लेट्स गो टू दिस न्यू कंसेप्ट ऑफ चेन होल्डिंग विच वॉज अ वेरी बिग आई वुड से शॉकर दैट हैज कम इन नवंबर 18 एग्जाम. ओके, एक्चुअली योर ओरिजिनल मॉड्यूल हैड गॉट नो कंसेप्ट ऑफ चेन होल्डिंग इन माई NDS, बट सडनली आउट ऑफ नो वेयर इन नवंबर 18 दे हैव आस्ड अ क्वेश्चन इन दैट. ओके, एंड दैट टू फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन कंपल्सरी. सो द लेसन दैट वी टुक फ्रॉम देयर, even if it is not in the module, it can come in the exam, right? And then afterwards, now institute in the new module has taken it. So your new module of 2019 onwards, they have included this concept now. Then how did you ask in May, November 18? But then I guess they must have given marks for that because it was actually out of syllabus. And there was also some mistake in the question and all that. There were some issues. But anyways, coming back to the point, chain holding, though it had come in our exam, okay, let me tell you one thing. Maybe India's concepts had not covered it, but in our accounting standard based consolidation, we had covered a concept called sub-subsidiaries. Sub-subsidiaries means what? A is holding in B, B is holding in C, right? And there we had learned how to do consolidation. So you could have applied the principles and done something in the paper. But chalo, now that is all over. Now from 19 onwards, definitely this can come in the exam. And we just have like one sum as of now, which institute has given. This is also exam question and this is also a module question. I think figures are just doubled. That's all they have done. Okay. So the question that we are going to do today is nothing but your November 18 and your module question. Like I said, only figures have doubled. That's it. Okay. So now before we get into this chain holding, what is a chain holding? As I just explained to you, two possible things are there. Okay. Let's say A is holding shares in B and B is holding shares in C, having control of course. So A is holding in B, let's say for example 90%, and B is holding in C, let's say for example 60%. Correct? So as per definition, can I say B is and C both are subsidiaries of A? Yes, they are. Okay. But in case of B, I am having a direct control, right or no? And whereas here I am having an indirect control. That is for sure. Why I am saying indirect? Because I am not having it directly. I am having it through my subsidiary. So if you look at the situation right now, can you tell me how much is NCI of B? NCI of B is how much? Definitely 10%. Bhai, NCI of B is 10%. So basically, B ke share capital mein 90% A is holding, so 10% NCI is holding. Now, if I look at C, what is the NCI of C? 40%. Do you agree? Just apparently, jo dikh raha hai wo, theek hai? This is a situation. Am I right? But now, if I give it a second thought, right? Second thought, like what second thought? Actually, A is holding in B 90 and B is holding in C 60. By virtue of definition or by virtue of control, there is no doubt that there is a control involved here. Okay? But if I see the effective holdings, effective, right? Kya ho raha effectively? If I see properly, if I look at C now, look at C. Ab C ke case mein, who is holding how much? Let's see. First, B is holding straight away 60%. I think that's no problem. Then we have B's NCI. B's NCI. Yes, they are also holding. Yes or no? Okay, let me put it in a different way. Wait a sec. Okay. Let me see A and C is how much. Simply. Indirectly now. How much? 90% of 60%. So can I simply put it? 54% we are holding in C. So iska matlab 46% is the NCI. अगर ऐसा I look at it in that way, तो 46% becomes the NCI, right or no? हाँ, सो इन दैट केस 46% बिकम्स द एनसीआई, बट ऐसा तो 40 दिख रहा था, देन व्हाट इज दैट 6% बेसिकली? एग्जैक्टली 6% ऑफ बी इज एनसीआई, ये जो 10% है ना, राइट, दीज 10% आर इनडायरेक्टली होल्डिंग 6%, बिकॉज 10% ऑफ 66%, बस यही पॉइंट है विच यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड कि भाई द एक्चुअल एनसीआई इज नॉट 40, इट इज एक्चुअली 46%. आई एम सीइंग एवरीथिंग फ्रॉम द एंगल ऑफ, हाँ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, आई एम सीइंग एवरीथिंग हियर फ्रॉम द एंगल ऑफ ए, एवरीथिंग इज ए's पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. इफ आई लुक एट बी इट्स प्रीटी सिंपल, व्हाट आई वाज टेलिंग यू अर्लियर वाज बी का एंगल, बी का एंगल 60% एंड 40% फिनिश्ड. ओके, बट व्हेन आई लुक एट ए's एंगल देयर बिकम्स अ चेंज इन दैट, वेयर ए विल से बाबा आई एम होल्डिंग 90 ऑफ 60 एंड दैट रिमेनिंग इज होल्डिंग 46 एज इन द एनसीआई. Okay, so all this that I'm talking about here is nothing but what I'm talking about, the indirect method. Okay, so in indirect method, what you do is, when you're doing consolidation under this chain holding, you can do it in two ways. One is we call it the direct method and one we call the indirect method. So in direct method and indirect method, what is the difference? I'll explain. Indirect method, I don't really bother about that NCI here and there, nothing. Okay, I simply say okay, 90% and 60%. This direct method we have done. We have done where? When we were doing our accounting standard based questions. In our book one. Where A and B, B and C hota tha, toh we used to first close C. C we used to absorb in B. Remember? And then B we used to absorb in A. So it was direct method where A was only interested in B. Ki C will come in B. And then B ka consolidated figure will eventually come in A. But I used to not say A and C anything. No. As you see the A and B, that's all I used to see. So, yahan pe kya hota tha? We used to go exactly like this only. A used to only take over B. Haan, B ka C consolidated used to come indirectly. But of course, A was not considering C in any way. Yaad hai na? So, this part, my dear, we have already covered. And this part is not so much which my institute is recommending for Ind AS. So, the question that we are going to do today is based on indirect method. Okay. Where in indirect method, how the working is done, how the things are done, and how the presentation comes, we are going to be learning there. Okay. So, institute has still not come out with the suggested answers, but the fact that they have come out with a module with this question, they have clearly given indirect method. So, we will stick to that only. That does not mean direct method we have not learned. We have learned it in our book one. And if you get a question on AS, accounting standards, you prefer direct method because that's what we have learned and we are comfortable with. But if you get Ind AS, prefer this. Okay, this indirect method. So what happens in this indirect method? So now everything I'm going to talk from the angle of A. I'm repeating. So back to my question now. Remember, A is holding in B, B is holding in C, 90% and 60%. यही था ना सिचुएशन. तो नाउ व्हाट विल आई डू इज सिंपली, ए इज हैविंग इन्वेस्टमेंट इन बी इन देयर बुक्स, व्हाट एवर अमाउंट दे आर पेड नॉर्मल. तो गुडविल वर्किंग के लिए दैट विल ओनली कम रेगुलर नॉर्मल अमाउंट. बट जो बी इज होल्डिंग इन्वेस्टमेंट इन सी, ये रहेगा ना, राइट, दिस इन्वेस्टमेंट इन सी वी आर गोइंग टू बी स्प्लिटिंग अप. व्हाट विल वी डू? वी विल बी स्प्लिटिंग इट अप. How will we splitting? How will we split it? How much percentage would we take? 90%. Exactly. So, it's a 90% ka investment. Only that we will consider for goodwill working. Okay? And jo baki ka 10% will be going where? Logically. NCI ke working. That's all you have to understand. Theek hai? Don't, matlab, no need to get too much into unnecessary details and all. Simply speaking, I will only be considering that much. इज इट क्लियर? तो जो भी अपना परसेंटेज का होल्डिंग इज देयर दैट मच आई बी कंसिडरिंग एज माई इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड माई गुडविल बी वर्कड आउट इन द सेम मैनर. एंड बाकी का जो 10% ऑफकोर्स हाउ विल माई बैलेंस शीट टैली व्हेन आई एम स्प्लिटिंग अप. तो बाकी का भी 10 समथिंग आई हैव टू डू, दैट समथिंग आई विल डू इन माई एनसीए. ओके, सो द बेस्ट वे ऑफ लर्निंग दिस इज डूइंग द सम. सो विल बी डूइंग द सम राइट नाउ, बट रिमेंबर आई एम डूइंग इट अंडर द इनडायरेक्ट मेथड. ओके, मे आई? श्योर? Boys writing? Okay. So, before we get, Institute has given a few examples, so it's my job to see, show you those. See there. Situation 1. 80% P is holding in S and 60% S1 is holding in S2. Right? So, effectively 48% we are holding. 48% of S2. Does it mean it's not my subsidiary? Of course it is. Ye effective holding it does not matter. If I have control over you, I have control over whoever you have control. ठीक है, this only for the sake of consolidation ki 48% will come to me. Okay? NCI in S1 is holding 12%. कैसे 12%? ये 60% का 20%. ठीक है, एंड जो नॉर्मल डायरेक्ट NCI is holding remaining 40%. So effectively ये 52% is held by NCI. I already showed you this with 90 and 60 example. Same thing. Then, situation 2 dekho. And tell me, have we done this also somewhere? P is holding in S1 80%. S1 is holding in S2 75%. And P is also holding in S2 10%. Do you remember doing this triangular holding? इन आ अगेन बुक 1. देखो इंडिया एस में ना ज्यादा कुछ दिया नहीं उन्होंने, ट्राइंगुलर होल्डिंग, क्रॉस होल्डिंग्स एंड ऑल, बट द फैक्ट दैट दे हैव आस्क्ड यू चेन होल्डिंग्स मीन्स दे कैन ऑल्सो आस्क यू दिस नाउ. सो यू कैन यूज द सेम सम्स विच वी हैव डन इन ए बुक 1 एंड यू कैन यू नो ट्राई इट आउट विद दिस. कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ने वाला है. ठीक है, अनलेस ऑफकोर्स फेयर वैल्यू चेंजेस कम. I hope it's clear. वैसे in this case, can I say P is indirectly holding कितना percent? P is indirectly holding in S2 80 of 75. 60 indirect, 10 direct. But still my subsidiary is indirectly only there. Are you clear? ठीक है. So that also they have given the example in my institute module. This is module, all what I'm showing you. Fair enough. Then, अच्छा same example में can you tell me minority का कैसे रहेगा? This S1 का direct minority will be 20%. Am I right? NCI. Then, is S2 का minority will be 80 and 75. क्या है उसका माइनॉरिटी? देखो डायरेक्ट माइनॉरिटी इज 15%, दैट इज फॉर श्योर, राइट? बिकॉज 10 and 75, करेक्ट और नो? सो वॉट इज द रिमेनिंग देन? 80 of 25 ना, 80 of 25 हाउ मच? 20 is holding. हाँ, so how much is that? 15%. ये बोलना है हमको. I wanted to ask you that NCI of SI is holding 15%. कौन सा? हाँ, 10 हम भी होल्ड कर रहे हैं सिंह. हाँ, राइट 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 राइट, यू राइट. या ठीक है. सो इफ यू लुक एट इट इफेक्टिवली 20% डायरेक्ट, 15% ये 25 माइनस 10 व्हाट वी जस्ट सेड. ओके, ये 15 एंड रिमेनिंग इनडायरेक्ट. गॉट इट? सो लाइक दिस वी आर हैविंग दिस टोटल 30%. okay, 30% in which I am saying overall, correct or no? Effective, yeah. I hope you're done this part, okay? So effectively, eventually, what is happening? Group ka 60% interest hai, that we got. Directly 10% we are already holding. Or 30% my dear minority is holding. So we can look at it in that way also. So aisa karke they have given us this whole thing. Once you understand this structure, then they say you can go further with the sums. But honestly speaking, jo sum they have given doesn't require so much of detail thing, because they have not given so many things out there. Simple working. They have still not given triangular holding yet. Okay. So let's come straight to the problem. Prepare the CBS on 31st March of the group of companies comprising of P, S and SS. Balance sheets are given to you. Regular normal balance sheet I can see. Yes or no? Anything special you noticed in the balance sheet? I have noticed one hidden adjustment. Exactly. Bills payable, my dear, intercompany I can see. P and SS, right? So somewhere bills receivable may also, that would be considered. So we have an intercompany owings there. Second, there is a institute has made one mistake. They have, what they have done is, in the module they have doubled all the figures, but they forgot to double these number of shares. Ye double kar do sirf, 64 and 48. नहीं सॉरी हाफ करना है हाफ या मैंने चेंज कर दिया है मैंने चेंज करके दिया है क्या हाँ आई हैव चेंज इट मॉड्यूल में अलग है आंसर तुम्हारे बुक में 16 एंड मैंने मेरे नोट्स में आई चेंज इट सो यू हैव दैट सो दिस इज द फाइनल फिगर 32 एंड 24 ठीक है नाउ एज वी कैन सी P is holding 80% in S and S is holding 75% in SS. So P in S, S in SS. P is holding 80% and 75%. So what is the effective holding? So basically P in SS is 60%, 80% of 75. So obviously what will be my NCI in SS? The remaining 40%. Wo triangle holding bhul jao, that in the middle of nowhere it came. So unnecessary confusion. Stick to this first. I hope it's clear. And what will be S ka thing? In S how it is? S is very clear. 80% they are holding, 20% minority. You see, SS ke liye have to think of this indirect pattern. Okay, I hope this is clear. Ye first working hai. Okay. Then, business is not seasonal and therefore it can be assumed that profits are earned evenly throughout the year. Even if you don't tell me, na, I do the same thing. Profits are earned evenly. That's why we divide it straight away without thinking. Correct? On 1st April 1, the following balances stood in the books. Tell me, when did we acquire the shares? Where is the given, where they given the acquisition? Holding, sorry, I missed out this sentence. The holding was acquired on 30th September 1. Today, what is the date given? 31st March 2. So it has happened during the year. During the year, September 30th means 6 months here, 6 months there. Or 1st April ka they have given me reserves and retained earnings. Dekho sir, reserves and retained earnings. Ye jo figure hai, 100, 80, 50, 60 is all about 31st March. They gave me 1st April. But I want 30th September. मुझे तो DOA चाहिए ना सो यहाँ पे एक स्मॉल कैच. ओके, सो यू विल थिंक ओ इट जस्ट कंपेयर रिजर्व्स विद दिस रिजर्व्स. नो, दिस इज ऑन 1st April, दैट इज ऑन 31st March, एंड आई वॉन्ट 1st 30th September, सो आई नीड टू टेक केयर ऑफ दैट. फिर स्मॉल इन्वेंट्री एडजस्टमेंट, 10 lakh इन द फिगर ऑफ एस इज इन्वेंट्री परचेज फ्रॉम SS. हु सोल्ड टू हुम? SS सोल्ड टू S, सो इट इज अ अपस्ट्रीम. याद है ना अपस्ट्रीम? SS सोल्ड टू S तो अपस्ट्रीम, तो हुज प्रॉफिट इज अफेक्टेड? SS. तो वी नीड टू टेक केयर ऑफ दैट एट कॉस्ट प्लस 25%. ठीक है. द पेरेंट हैज अडॉप्टेड एन अकाउंटिंग पॉलिसी टू मेजर NCI एट फेयर वैल्यू, सो दे ऑल्सो पुट NCI एट फेयर वैल्यू हियर. कोटेड मार्केट प्राइस अप्लाइंग 103. ठीक है. अज्यूमिंग द मार्केट प्राइस ऑफ SNSS आर द सेम एज देयर फेस वैल्यू, सो बेसिकली दे वॉन्ट मी टू टेक दिस एट द फेस वैल्यू विच इज द फेयर वैल्यू. ओके, सो वंस मोर क्विकली एनालाइज द क्वेश्चन प्रॉपरली. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. Actually, since I have only one question, I have to call this only very, very important. We need some more sums from institute, whether they want triangular holdings, whether they want this. Suppose they give that, then we have to again take some extra sums on that. Okay? Till now, they haven't given. So, let's stick. Even cross-holding, they have not said anything. Okay? So, let's stick to what they have given us. Go through the sum once again properly. Done? So, shall I go to the working notes? Balance sheet, format, same thing again and again. Just before doing anything else, you should be clear with this picture. This is very important. I hope this is clear. This. We'll present it in the form of a working note. But this is the key. Okay? Shall we write down? Pehle balance sheet format we'll make. Come on. Consolidated balance sheet of P Limited Group on 31st March. Can write in lakhs. So non-current assets, we have only PPE. I don't think there's any adjustment in PPE, so we don't need, and in fact there are no fair value changes also. Did you observe? दे गेव यू चेन होल्डिंग, तो बाकी कुछ दिया ही नहीं उन्होंने एडजस्टमेंट्स. सो पीपी नो रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ नोट. देन वी हैव आवर इन्वेंट्री. आई थिंक वी हैव एन एडजस्टमेंट इन दैट. Under your financial assets, we have, I guess, trade receivables and trade. Nee, they have given dono na. Trade receivables, mein, there's no adjustment, so we can take it directly. Bills receivable, we have some intercompany na. So we'll take it separately. Note. Cash is there. no adjustment, only total. शेयर कैपिटल, अदर इक्विटी, या एनसीआई, the financial liabilities you do have trade payables, right? And bills payable. So you can manage with four notes. Four lines, five lines, each note you can keep. Only keep your other equity big. Other equity keep about 10 lines. Done? चलो, working note one. Your effective interest or your shareholding pattern. ना 80% है पी इन एस वन, इज इट एस वन और जस्ट एस? जस्ट एस. ओके, देन वी हैव एस एन एस एस. सेवेंटी फाइव परसेंट. Therefore, effective interest of P in SS 80% of 75%. Therefore, my NCI is going to be 40%. I am repeating, this is for P in SS. I am doing P in SS absolutely crystal clear. 80-20 NCI khatam. Okay, working note 2. योर वर्किंग नोट टू इज गोइंग टू बी फॉर योर नेट एसेट्स, है ना. नाउ सिंस आई हैव गॉट टू सब्सिडरीज, देखा गया तो एस ऑल्सो एंड एस एस ऑल्सो, सो आई हैव टू हैव एटलीस्ट फोर कॉलम्स, प्री पोस्ट, प्री पोस्ट फॉर एस एंड एस एस. बट लाइक आई ऑलवेज टेल यू कि जो प्री है सिंगल कॉलम इज ओके, बट जब पोस्ट है आई हैव टू सी हाउ मेनी रिजर्व्स आर देयर एंड हाउ मेनी चेंजेस आर देयर इन द रिजर्व्स. हाउ मेनी रिजर्व्स यू आर सीइंग ओवर हियर? टू रिजर्व्स, एक रिजर्व्स है और एक रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स है, एंड आई गेस बोथ आर चेंजिंग. सी इट वॉज 80-60 एंड नाउ इट इज 180, बोथ हैव चेंज्ड. This has also changed. Retained earnings have also changed. So in other words, I have changes in my post column for both. So what I need to do? I need to keep a separate column for retained earnings and for reserves. So kya karenge abhi? S ke teen columns. And SS also three columns I have. क्या थ्री कॉलम्स भाई? दिस इज द प्री पार्ट, दिस इज गोइंग टू बी पोस्ट, बट पोस्ट फॉर बोथ रिजर्व्स एंड रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स. दिस विल बी प्री पोस्ट फॉर रिजर्व्स एंड रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स. डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई आई डिड? सी पोस्ट में एक्स्ट्रा कॉलम्स होते हैं, प्री में आई डोंट हैव टू बॉदर, एवरीथिंग इज वन कैपिटल प्रॉफिट. You will not need much space, about 7-8 lines should be enough because there are no fair value changes here. Then as always, working note 3 for my cost of control. For 2, I'm having it. For S and for SS. You have your cost of acquisition. You have your NCI. Remember, NCI is at fair value. So, leave one or two lines to calculate the fair value. Get your total. And then less net assets on DOA. You will get your goodwill or your bargain purchase gain. See, stick to the format, there will be no confusion. The moment you start doing something different, problem. Working note 4, I will have of minority NCI. Again, two columns for S and SS. And my dear, I have avoided working note 5. That was my reserves. Or you want to keep it, retained earnings? You want to maintain it? कर लो फिर, जान लो, कंफ्यूजन मत करो. ठीक है, कंसोलिडेटेड रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स. सो लाइक ऑलवेज आई हैव माई 5 कॉलम्स रेडी, 5 वर्किंग नोट्स आई मीन, माई नोट्स आर रेडी, माई फॉर्मैट इज रेडी, एंड नाउ आई स्टार्ट विद द रेगुलर स्टफ. So far, what did we see new? This. Of SS. If I was doing the direct method, toh my NCI would have been 25%. Kaunsa 25? 80 and 75 hai na? Toh remaining 25, that's it. Finished. That effective thing wouldn't have come. But now that effective thing has come. Okay? By the way, now my NCI is how much? In S it is 20%, huh? एस का 20% इज गॉन नोवेयर, एस एस इट इज 40%. हैड आई बीन डूइंग द डायरेक्ट मेथड इट वुड हैव बीन 20% सेम फॉर एस, बट एस एस वुड हैव बीन 25%. आर यू क्लियर? चलो सो लेट्स स्टार्ट माई सेकेंड स्टेप नाउ. स्टेप वन फॉर्मैट ओवर, स्टेप टू लाइन बाय लाइन, वन बाय वन, लेट्स गो फॉर इट. शाल आई? फर्स्ट थिंग, कम ऑन, लाइन बाय लाइन, पीपी, एनी एडजस्टमेंट्स इन पीपी? नो, सिंपली टोटल रुपीज एंड लैक्स यू हैव रिटन इन द बिगनिंग. 980, जस्ट पुट द टोटल फिगर. इन्वेस्टमेंट्स, नेक्स्ट आइटम, यस यू आर राइट, बट रिमेंबर एस एस के केस में वी आर ओनली गोइंग टू टेक ये जो है ना, दिस टू थ्री, कितना दिया है यहाँ पे, 280. दिस 280 माई डियर इज फॉर द होल थिंग that we have paid, but I am doing indirect method, so I'll be only taking my share. How much is my share in 280? 80%. देखो तुम भूल रहे हो, कितना था वो initial? 80 and 75, right? We are talking of investment in SS. In whose books are we? S के books में we are seeing investment in SS. तो इस investment में how much have you contributed? 80%. That's why I'm saying 80%. Don't see this. वो effective के लिए I've already taken. That is over. Now I'm talking of investment जो किया है ना SS में. In that me, I have contributed only 80%. And my minority has put the remaining 20%. Are you clear? So 80%. 80% of 280. Of course, my balance sheet will not tally if I don't take that remaining amount. Line by line, every figure is to be taken something. So remaining 56 will go away, 20%. NCI, I'm bilkul right. But will I show it as plus or will I show it as minus? Plus. Bhai, this is investment debit. And NCI is liability credit. Samjha? If I'm going in the way of debit credit normal funda, so this should not be a plus figure, na? It should be a minus figure. De. Correct? So less aayega. NCI share of investment. NCI without doing anything, they are also getting na, that 20%. Without doing anything, unko reserves ka 20% they are going to get. So then if you are getting 20, then you also bear the cost of that 20. Na? This is that cost of that 20. Did you understand? Free mein nothing you are going to get. You are taking na reserves free mein, toh chalo take the cost also. NCI share 20% of 280. And minus kyun samjha na? Bhai, this is investment and NCI is liability. Debit, cost of investment hai. So this is minus. Okay? Next what I have. सो ये इसको स्टार मार्क करो, दिस इज समथिंग न्यू यू आर डूइंग, नेवर डन दिस बिफोर. दिस इज द इनडायरेक्ट मेथड, ये ही स्पेशल है इन दिस इनडायरेक्ट मेथड. नेक्स्ट आइटम आई हैव इन्वेंट्री, कैन आई जस्ट राइट इट? उसमें कुछ एडजस्टमेंट है ना, तो जस्ट राइट द फिगर राइट नाउ. पी एस एंड एस एस 220, 70 and 50. ट्रेड रिसीवेबल्स नो एडजस्टमेंट, स्ट्रेट टोटल इन द बैलेंस शीट. Okay, bills receivable is showing P72 and SS30 in your note number 2. Correct? And cash and bank again simply the total. Cash and bank just take your total. I think my assets are over. Okay. You sure? Now my own share capital 600. Like always in my share capital. Done. S Limited share capital. Remember, S Limited will go where? Share capital. Share capital cost mein jana band ho gaya abhi. Kyun? Kyunki you are taking net assets yahan pe, right? So take it here. क्या करें, इंस्टीट्यूट की गलती है. पहले एएस भी बोलते कंसोलिडेशन. बच्चा समटाइम्स स्टार्ट्स अंडरस्टैंडिंग एएस सडनली इंड एएस दे चेंज एवरीथिंग. स्टार्ट अंडरस्टैंडिंग नॉर्मल सडनली चेन होल्डिंग दे पुट. करेक्ट ना? क्या करें, आदत से मजबूर. सो व्हाट नेक्स्ट आई हैव 400 विल कम हियर एंड 320 इन एसएस. आर यू क्लियर? Of course, we have to think of minority also, but not now, later. My own reserves, where will they go? Line by line going on in my reserves. Other equity, consolidated retained earnings. So my own reserves, 180 in the inner column. What about 180? जो 100 है एस का, समथिंग दे हैव टोल्ड मी ना, रिजर्व्स वर सो मच. देखो, लुक एट एस. रिजर्व्स वर 80. टुडे दे आर एस के कॉलम में 100. सो 80 हैज बिकम 100. सो 20 इज द इंक्रीज आई कैन क्लियरली सी. So 20 increase will go where? Proportionate. Very good. Post में मत बोलो. क्यों post में नहीं? I'll tell you. Reserves का date देखो क्या दिया है? 1/4 को दिया है. You forgot. Reserves are given on 1/4. Pre column में 80 है S का. Correct? समझा? 60 is SS. तो that you put in pre column. That is the sure ना 1/4. एंड देन इंक्रीज इन रिजर्व जो हुआ है, इट विल बी डिवाइडेड इन द रेशियो 6 months 6 months. हाँ, हैड दे गिवन मी रिजर्व बैलेंस ऑन सेप्टेंबर, कि सेप्टेंबर का बैलेंस वॉज 80, देन यू वुड हैव सेड आर रिमेनिंग 20 इज पोस्ट. बट यू गेव मी 1/4, राइट? एंड यू आस्क मी 30 सेप्टेंबर, तो आई नीड टू टेक ना इंक्रीज. तो कितना इंक्रीज है रिजर्व? 20. सो इट विल बी 10 year एंड 10 year. समझा? 100 माइनस 80, 6 months 6 months. एस एस वॉज 60, इज 80, तो 20, अगेन उसमें भी 20 इंक्रीज, 10 इट्स अ को इंसिडेंट है, बोथ आर 10 10, नहीं तो बोलेंगे एवरी टाइम इट विल कम लाइक दैट, नो। डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड? आर यू श्योर? फिर से देखो एक बार, 1 4 बैलेंस गिवन, 31 मार्च बैलेंस गिवन, इंक्रीज ड्यूरिंग द ईयर, राइट? लाइक हाउ वी डू प्रॉफिट ना, सेम वे। सो देर इज अ 6 months, 6 months डिविजन इन द टू। नाउ वॉट नेक्स्ट? रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स खुद के 160, वर्किंग नोट 5। बैलेंस 160, टेक योर टाइम, नो प्रॉब्लम। नाउ 50 एंड 60 गिवन, दैट टाइम इट वॉज 20। वापस वही करना पड़ेगा, रिटेन्ड अर्निंग्स ऑन 1 4 20 एंड 30 एंड इंक्रीज, कैन यू डू इट योर सेल्फ? इंक्रीजेस 50 माइनस 20, एंड 60 माइनस 30 इन 6 months इज टू 6 months। पुट इट इन रिटेन्ड कॉलम, हाँ। इफ यू टेक दिस इन पोस्ट माई डियर, द फुल अमाउंट, योर सम इज ओवर देर एंड देन, देन यू आर ओनली वेस्टिंग टाइम। बी केयरफुल विथ योर डेट्स, आई हैव ऑलवेज टोल्ड यू, डेट ऑफ एक्विजिशन, डेट ऑफ रिजर्व, डेट ऑफ चेंज, एवरीथिंग इज ऑन दैट डेट, वेरी केयरफुल है। इज इट क्लियर? सी, बट नो डिविडेंड एडजस्टमेंट, नो रीवैल एडजस्टमेंट, राइट? वन स्मॉल इन्वेंट्री का एडजस्टमेंट एंड इंटर कंपनी ड्यूज। आई होप यू आर क्लियर। नेक्स्ट, ट्रेड पेबल्स नो एडजस्टमेंट, स्ट्रेट टोटल। एंड बिल्स पेबल, रिमेंबर दे आर इंटर कंपनी, तो यहां पे बिल्स पेबल हैव रिटन 70 प्लस 30, बट एंटायर 70 एंड 30 इज इंटर कंपनी, एम आई राइट? तो यहां पे इंटर कंपनी ड्यूज फ्रॉम बोथ लाइबिलिटीज एंड एसेट्स यू माइनस, ये देखो यहां पे लेस इंटर कंपनी ड्यूज 100, स्टिल 2 विल रिमेन, दैट इज सम आउटसाइड पर्सन वी हैव। योर एंटायर 100 बिल्स पेबल इज इंटर कंपनी, सो माइनस 100, बोथ केसेज यू माइनस 100, लाइक डेटर क्रेडिटर, लाइक बिल्स पेबल रिसीवेबल, ठीक है? आर यू क्लियर? वॉट मोर? फिनिश लाइन बाय लाइन, ओवर। पी का क्या? नहीं, राइट है ना? देखो, बिल्स रिसीवेबल पी इज शोइंग 72, कि टू सम आउटसाइड पीपल का रहेगा ना, 70 इज पेएबल टू इंटर कंपनी, ठीक है, हो गया। एसएस का 30 30 डायरेक्ट नॉक ऑफ। पॉइंट नंबर वन, पी होल्ड्स 80, 75 होल्डिंग्स अक्वायर्ड ऑन सितंबर, डन। बिजनेस नॉट सीजनल, देयरफॉर थ्रू आउट द ईयर, इसलिए 6 months 6 months डिवाइडेड। थर्ड, फर्स्ट अप्रैल बैलेंसेस वर सो मच, सो फर्स्ट अप्रैल वी टुक इंक्रीज, वी टुक डिवाइडेड, ऑल्सो फिनिश्ड। पॉइंट नंबर फोर, लेट्स सी, 10 lakh in S is inventory from SS. So who sold? SS. Whose profit? SS profit. Unrealized profit minus from SS. Now, when did they sell the inventory? Have they given me the date? No. So inventory could have been sold during the year anytime. Before acquisition, after acquisition. Kahin pe bhi ho sakta hai. But for ease and convenience, I always take it as after acquisition. Pre-co, I don't touch unnecessarily. Theek hai? So minus from where? Kiska column? SS ka column, right? But SS which column? Retained earnings. Retained earnings is your P&L, samajh lo tum. Less. Adjustment I'm doing in green, okay? Unrealized profit. URP, unrealized profit. Kitna inventory hai? 10 lakh. Which is purchased at cost plus 25. So into 25 by 125. We have done these adjustments before. So unrealized profit is 2. This 2 ka second effect minus from? Minus from. Inventory. Unrealized profit inventory 2. See, jiska profit unrealized from the U minus and inventory. Actually, SK inventory mein it is lying, but I have already taken consolidated, so it's okay. And I guess I'm done now. Point number 5, very important. Star mark point. You have to take your NCI at fair value. And the fair value is nothing but their face value. Ye bola hai na? So my NCI starting point is the fair value. Koi baat nahi. So now let me see. What is NCI percentage? Shareholding pattern dekho. S mein NCI is how much? S. 20%. I didn't write S, but I hope you understood. And SS mein it is 40%. S mein 20, SS mein 40. And this fair value is of your face value. So S ka share capital, see how much is S? Share capital? 400, so 400 into 20%. So share capital. And iska share capital, my dear? 320 into how much percentage? 40%. Kyunki NCI ka we are seeing na 40% effective. Right. Remember, this NCI only becomes your starting point of NCI. Fair value on DOA. Done? Are you sure? Shall I do my closing now? See, all my adjustments are over. My line by line is over. Now closing is the last thing I have. So, sabse pehle take your totals. $425. This one. $435. Check it out. Remember, this is 100%. राइट, इवन माई गुडविल कॉस्ट अपना लिया, एनसीआई का लिया, तो दैट ऑल्सो बिकम्स 100%. तो सबसे पहले तो वॉट विल यू डू, दिस यू राइट इन योर योर फिनिश दैट वन थिंग. सो माई गुडविल आई एम फ्री नाउ, राइट, बट डोंट जम्प टू गुडविल, वेट वेट. फर्स्ट राइट ऑल द फिगर्स. नाउ वॉट विल हैपन विद द पोस्ट थिंग्स? पोस्ट ऑल्सो आई टेक फुल क्या? नो, पोस्ट आई डिवाइडेड, प्री आई टेक फुल. पोस्ट आई डिवाइडेड बिटवीन पेरेंट एंड एनसीआई. अब समझा, पेरेंट एंड एनसीआई, हाउ मच इज पेरेंट इन एस? पेरेंट इन एस इज 80% एंड देयर इट इज इन एसएस इट इज 60%. समझा ना? Effective, effective. Forget that 75, 25, it's gone. And NCI will be 20 and 40. Can you take the four figures now? S ke liye take 80%. Are you clear? Now you have got eight figures in front of you. Where you are going to take these eight figures? Sare post figures, all are post figures. You know, post goes to my reserve. Jo reserve, it will go to reserve. PNL, PNL may go, it will go. Retained earnings, retained may, it will go. Correct or no? Capital reserve, capital reserve may, it will go. Whatever post, whichever reserve it stands for, goes there. So here, tell me, where will eight go? Sabse pehla eight. This will be in reserves. Remember, working nobility. Note number 4. Wait. Finish telling me, then you can write down. 8 will go there, I agree. What about this 6? 6 will also go there. It is my share only, na, indirect. Yeah. And what about this 12 and 7.8? Ye retained earnings mein jayega, consolidate. Matlab idhar. Ye likh lu pehle. Plus post acquisition reserve or retained earnings of S and SS 12 and 7.8. Here, have you written? Now take this 8 and 6 over here. Plus post acquisition reserve. S and SS. 8 and kitna tha? 7.8 na? Sorry, 8 and 6. Okay. Okay. Are you done? And baki ke 4 figures dal do seedha in NCI. NCI mein you can write down. Post acquisition reserves and post acquisition retained earnings. I hope you're done. Right, no? 2 and 4 under reserve, right? Get your goodwill. Can you put this in the main answer now? Capital reserve. NCI is 29 plus 137.2, no? How much was the P&L? 170? Okay. Do it, no problem. See the tally properly? Did you understand the chain holding question? Did you see? Only one dividend ka, dividend bol rahi. Investment ka adjustment if you get, there's nothing much. Frankly speaking, don't even bother too much about it. You know, unnecessarily then you get confused. Indirect method, okay, like this is done, finish it off. Had it been direct method, what I would have done? Directly, C bol rahi. SS, we would have taken an S. And then S, we would have taken in P. P will have no connection with SS directly. It would be only P and S. That way is what we have done in IAS. But I would say that they prefer this one only. So you go with this one. Okay? I hope this that triangular holding thing is clear. There have been old syllabus mein questions where they specifically told you also to use direct or indirect method. Aisa hua hai. So you read the question properly. That possibility is there. If they tell you, do under this method. But chances are they will give you indirect in this case. They can give you direct in the AS case. ठीक है? वो triangular holding का clear है ना? This part? Yes or no? So one last question for some triangle holding. Again, tell me. Just like that. Question. Just one. No, it's me any I go. I have to change it. Yeah. I know you understood. Okay. Now fine? Chalo. फर्स्ट तो नॉर्मल एनसीआई निकाल लो, राइट? नॉर्मल एनसीआई हाउ मच योर, मतलब डायरेक्ट एनसीआई 40%, राइट? ठीक है. दिस एनसीआई 10%. आर यू गेटिंग? ओके. एंड देन इनडायरेक्टली हाउ मच इज जेड एक्स होल्डिंग देयर? X is holding how much? 42. Indirectly, I am saying, indirectly. 60 of 70. So indirectly we are holding 42%. Correct now? Directly we are holding 20%. This is indirect. Directly we are holding 20%. This one. Correct or no? And then, baki ka 38% is minority. Right or no? NCI 10% direct or NCI indirect? Yes. 40 of 70. Correct or no? 28. Kaise bhi ghuma lo? 100. Okay? So I would suggest if you make diagram now, you will not be confused. So make, write this example so that it's clear. Without diagram, it like institute tries to do directly, na thoda confusing hota hai. If you do with diagram, no confusion whatsoever. All this is for Z, huh? From X angle, we are doing it for Z company. And from X angle for Y company, it's very straightforward. 60 and 40. Okay, just one small logic which I want to explain to you. This you have done now. Ye na, ye dekho. Yahan pe somewhere, you know, this particular part. This part I'm talking about, huh? Pay attention here. In SS, that 224 I have taken, right? 224 I have taken proportionate cost, remember. Hai na? How much is this percentage of, like, how much percentage is this of that SS? I think my question is not clear. 80 and 75. Rather now, 80 and 75. Can I say this 224 is for 60%? मतलब 60% का ना ये फंडा. दिस इज फॉर एक्चुअली 60% ऑफ दैट कैपिटल, राइट? एंड माइनॉरिटी इज 40. सो इफ आई डोंट टेक प्रपोर्शनेट, इफ आई डोंट टेक प्रपोर्शनेट एंड आई वुड हैव टेकन 280, तो क्या हो जाता था? दिस 280 वुड हैव बीन फॉर मोर देन, मतलब ये 80% का नहीं, 100% का प्लस माइनॉरिटी 40 वुड हैव टेकन, तो आई वुड हैव टेकन मोर देन 100. Are you getting it? By reducing this proportionately, now I am taking this 60% of your investment plus 40% minority, 100% aisa hota hai. Because minority ka 40 is clear. Then this also should be 60 na. How come you are taking 75% ka cost? To isko proportionately I will show you in another way. Take on a calci. 280 you had spent for 75% shares, am I right? but I want this for 60% shares. So 280 divided by 75 into 60. I'm doing the same thing, just mathematically I'm showing in a different way. So 224 will come like that. 80% tum aisa socho, like 80% directly, or you think 80 of this 75 and iska 60% and 40%, like that. Both ways will come to the same point. Okay, that explains why I have to take it less in this cost. Because minority I'm taking 40, so how can I take cost more than 60 na? Then it will become 100 ke upar total, which is not acceptable. So this is the basic chain holding ka indirect method. Okay, so for homework, if you want, you can take November 18 ka question and solve it. Same question hai. Sirf figures I think half hai shayad. Okay, fine. This is your module question which we just did. So let's hope they don't give us more triangular and cross holding. Let's hope. But if they do, then again I'll put it on YouTube later on. Okay, that's it. Okay.